Good morning, Newcastle, and a very pleasant welcome as don't adapt your set. We're getting there as we bounce around for this Thursday morning. And what a Thursday morning it is. Well, let's take a look and we'll have to come back to that a little bit later. And let's get everybody along our channel on. Hope you're doing well. 60 degrees in Newcastle, and absolutely gorgeous couple of days we've had. We're gonna get into a really nice looking weekend, and that'll be pretty special, as there's a lot of great activities going on from Elwood to New Wilmington and every place in between. You got a great chance to get out, just enjoy, kind of hark back to maybe those nice summer days when life was a little less scheduled, and that's a great thing. As we kind of breeze through here, and there we hit our last group. Couple more things. People, I slept in this morning. Usually I'm up 4:30. Next thing I looked, it was 5 o'clock, and just totally amazed that everything had passed that quickly. Now, as we continue, I only got one more thing to do. I want to check it out. Let's check and one more thing I wanted to do, and doesn't seem to have cooperated the way I'd like there. So the train is on the tracks, and Newswatch is straight ahead for you. One more thing I wanted to do, and
broadcasting from the greatest castle in the world, in the county of Lawrence, NCTV 45.
Have cooperated the way I'd like there. So the train is on the tracks, and Newswatch is straight ahead for you. one more thing I want.
Entrusting your loved one to a funeral director.
Broadcasting from the greatest castle in the world.
Emotional decision.
In the county of Lawrence.
Funeral director, you choose, must understand the importance of the decision you have made. When you call the William and Roger DiCarbo Funeral Home, I recognize what a privilege it is to be chosen at your time of need. We will provide you and your family with the best service possible, with sincerity and compassion.
The William and Roger DiCarbo Funeral Home, family owned and operated since 1941.
If you're craving hot dogs and more, and you're in the area,
trusting your loved ones to a funeral
broadcasting from the greatest castle in the world, in the county of Lawrence, NCT,
must understand the importance of the decision you have made. When you call the William and Roger DiCarbo Funeral Home, I recognize what a privilege it is to be chosen at your time of need. We will provide you and your family with the best service possible, with sincerity and compassion.
You can also buy a homemade
call the William and Roger DiCarbo Funeral Home. I recognize what a privilege it is to be chosen as your time of need. We will provide you and your family with the best service possible, with sincerity and compassion.
You can also buy a homemade
William and Roger DiCarbo Funeral Home. I recognize what a privilege it is to be chosen as your time of need. We will provide you and your family with the best service possible, with sincerity and compassion.
Of
the William and Roger DiCarbo Funeral Home. I recognize what a privilege it is to be chosen as your time of need. We will provide you and your family with the best service possible, with sincerity and compassion. Of the William and Roger DiCarbo Funeral Home. I recognize what a privilege it is to be chosen as your time of need. We will provide you and your family with the best service possible, with sincerity and compassion. William and Roger DiCarbo Funeral. I recognize what a privilege it is.
Good morning, Newcastle, and a very pleasant welcome to Thursday, the 26th of the month. And let's check out that weather. So I'll give you a first look here. It's 60 degrees. And they're saying overcast. Nah, maybe so. 86% humidity. Winds are calm. Barometric pressure 29.77, dew point 56, and visibility 10 miles. We're going to get more on the weather as we go through Newswatch. And we kind of told you, you get that rain last night and it would be clearing up as your Thursday went on. That's going to be totally true. So, just hang in there. Good things are coming. And, I'm not going to kill a point, but this is Thursday the 26th. Once today starts, I go, today has started. There's 4 days left till the end of the month. 31 days in October, so that means roughly 35, the 40th day is election day, so 39 days till election day. And once again, I want to tell you, Chris Fry, who believes in small business, has not walked through the door yet. Says he believes in small business. Maybe he just doesn't believe in this small business. We'll have to get and see. Now, as we continue on, you know, Project Educate does a lot of hard work with students with disabilities between 14 and 21. Well, they're going to have an informational workshop, and the way they wrote this, succeeding in local post-secondary education with a disability. This is, they had two of the workshops Tuesday and Wednesday. And their next workshop that I read, Succeeding in a Local Post-Secondary Education with a Disability, will be at the Newcastle Public Library, September 28th. And from 1 to 2, New Transition Services for Students and Disabilities. That'll be at in Aliquippa B.F. Jones Library, Aliquippa, and that'll be September 30th. So just to let you know, the 28th, and then that Saturday from 10 to 11, they're having that. You can RSVP, but walk-ins are always welcome. So make sure that you get that on your list. The Hoyt will open its 2019-20 music series, An Evening with Romantic Violin, on October 10th at 7, featuring violinist Andrew Swords, accompanied by Elizabeth DiMaio on piano. They reside in Cleveland, Ohio. Swords has an elaborate more than 300 orchestra pieces across the globe and was a classical musician to have competed in the Pittsburgh Dancing with the Stars. Okay. He has diverse interests and just won't go into that. He performed with romantic works of he will perform romantic works of Beethoven, Franck, Chopin, and more. This is the music series runs from now through March. Get more information by calling the Hoyt 724-652-2882 and enjoy that music series. Now, in keeping with the Hoyt, they have so many activities that go on there, and if you miss them, not everything isn't for everybody, but some of this is pretty good. The Hoyt is seeking high school entries for its upcoming countywide student art exhibit held at the Confluence January 7th through March 12th. All media will be considered, with the exception of video and installation. There will be cash prizes awarded. Public, private, homeschooled students 9 to 12. There's no entry fee. However, it must be submitted to the Hoyt no later than December 14th. And if you have a question, and for details to get the entry form, call the Hoyt 724-652-2882. And they'll give you that. Now, it's time to take a look at sports. I'm not even going to talk about the Pirates. Baseball season's come to an end, but let's see what's going on today, and we'll be right back. Take a look at sports.
The Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle wants you to indulge in the food from their pleasing menu. The Cedars features Mediterranean, pub food, Middle Eastern cuisine, and so much more. They're open every day, 11 a.m. The Cedars Restaurant in
Newcastle. Call the Cedars.
Once you indulge in 827 at a street in Newcastle, the Cedars features Mediterranean, pub food, Middle Eastern cuisine, and so much more. They're open every day, 11 a.m. The Cedars Restaurant in
Newcastle. Call the Cedars.
Once you indulge in 827 at a street in Newcastle, the Cedars features Mediterranean, pub food, Middle Eastern cuisine, and so much more. They're open every day. 11 a.m. Cedars Restaurant in
the Cedars.
Once you swim ball to 827 at Easy Maintenance. The Cedars features Mediterranean, pub foods, Middle Eastern cuisine, and so much more. They're open every day. 11 a.m. Cedars Restaurant in
the Cedars.
Once you swim ball to 827 at Easy Maintenance. The Cedars features Mediterranean, pub foods, Middle Eastern cuisine, and so much more. They're open every day. 11 a.m.
This program brought to you by Cummings Landscaping and Design, Brandon Cummings, Mower Operator. Penn, Ohio Bottled Water Company. Home, residential, commercial, water coolers. You can contact us Monday through Friday, 8 to 5 p.m. We're fast, efficient, and we deliver water. We offer 100% customer satisfaction guarantee. Contact us today at 724-498-4760. You know, I want to thank a couple people right now. Garrett, first of all, thank you for your text. And let me explain that. You know, when I'm sitting here, I click a button. I know I did. I'm crazy, but I'm not nuts. And then somehow that button gets unclicked. And I'm not real sure how that's happening, but it's driving me absolutely mad. So thanks, Garrett. I appreciate it. Number two, a shout out to my man Tim, because as I was sitting back and I'm looking at the sports, he's really got a good job on those logos. Way to go, Tim. So now back to a little Newswatch. You know, here's something ironic. Fetterman's on his recreational marijuana tour. Fetterman's the lieutenant governor. Now, that being said, Wolf is trying to reduce the stigma with opioid addiction. It doesn't make sense. The two don't relate. Let me explain something to you. I truly believe what I learned in high school was the correct fact. And they're saying marijuana is an entry-level drug. Entry-level to doing other things. Don't start it. You won't have problems with what's behind the tree, because it could be a whole mess of problems. So that coming from me, not the governor and his lieutenant that I think are accurate. Are you planning a trip abroad? Mike Kelly wants to know. Apply now for your U.S. passport. Why wait? September is Passport Month, during which the U.S. Department of State reminds travelers that fall and winter are the best times to submit applications to obtain new passports on or renew one that's expiring. The stress of pending applications as your trip dates is available, and so are the expedited fees. Avoid the rush and do it today. Okay, that in from Mike Kelly. And, you know, Mike, he's a great guy. He often gets us things that are, that's not Mike, this is necessary to kind of update you. So he tells you about the passport today. He's going to have a town hall meeting, 6:30. Call in 855-531-106 and listen and talk with Mike Kelly and town hall meeting, so he can take those issues to Washington. I think it's really important. And, you know, the weather. Well, here you go. When you take a look at what we have, 60 degrees, and it's just it's humid out there, 86%, but all this moisture is going to clear up. Barometric pressure 29.77, dew point 56, and visibility 10 miles. The overcast is the whole thing clearing up, and here's why. When you look at radar, you got some stuff up on the lake, but to our west, in our immediate west and northwest, you got nothing. This is ground clutter here, so let's go to Lawrence County 45 weather and check it out. We'll be right back. County 45 weather. Well, after last night's mostly cloudy low with those scattered showers of 61, how is your Thursday looking? Well, when you take a look at local radar, what you see is the ground clutter first, and that's going to give way though to some pretty great weather as you look at the national map. Now, nationally, you see nothing off to our northwest and west, and things just look absolutely great. So, what's your forecast look like? Well, your Thursday, the showers, the chance of showers is going to end before 9 o'clock. And mostly cloudy and gradually clearing with a high of 75. Thursday night, mostly clear and 48. Friday, sunshine and 76. Friday night, mostly cloudy, 62. Saturday, partly sunny and 81. Saturday night, mostly cloudy, 58. Sunday, sunshine, 80. Sunday night, partly cloudy, 61. Monday, sunshine, 83. Monday night, partly cloudy and 64. And Tuesday, sunshine and 84. That was Lawrence County 45 weather. You know, get out, enjoy that great weather.
Is brought to you by NCTV 45. And NC Radio 450, Newcastle's community television station.
Nico & Sons Sales and Service, 347 East Washington Street, Newcastle, has lawnmowers of every type. Zero turn country clippers, Bain the USA, 42 inch to 54 inch cut, batteries by Oregon. They'll service at your home or their shop. Service specials start as low as $69. Call Jim Micko & Sons, 724-652-6911.
If you're having a party, then Keystone Specialty is the place you need to go. Yes, they have every party supply that you can imagine. Planning that wedding, that graduation, or maybe it's just that big game that's coming up. Go to Keystone Specialty. Party supplies and so much more. Remember, they have those fall decorations, winter, spring, and summer. It's Keystone Specialty on the south side of Newcastle, Mill Street.
Vinte Se in Newcastle is a premier winery located on Newcastle's southeast side on Wilson Avenue. Vinte Se open Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Features a variety of fine wines and also fine food. Vinte Se for the very best.
Funding for this program furnished by Mary's Turner's Day Spa, Wilmington Road, Neshannock Township, Newcastle. Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450, Newcastle's community television station.
Hello and welcome back, and a couple things. Saturday, October 12th, Holy Spirit Parish Oktoberfest. That will be at the St. Joe's site from noon to 8. Free admission, traditional German food, live entertainment, so much more. Going to be a great time. Don't forget there's bingo at Mary Mother of Hope tonight. And that... doors open at 6:30. Kitchen opens. Check this. Doors open at 5:30. Kitchen opens at 6. Bingo starts at 6:45. Also, Farmers Market, Elwood, Newcastle, New Wilmington. Make sure you check that out. Vinte Se. Italian Fest, the 28th, noon to, it says, let me see this, Ashbet, 12 p.m. to 11 p.m. Italian Fest on the 28th, that's going to be a great time. Snow Queen down at the Playhouse, and Old Timers Day out of Cascade Park on Sunday the 29th. Door registration at 10. This is a Halloween theme. DJ Justin Buddha will be there. The Playhouse Mini All-Stars. It'll be another smashing good time. Autumn Bash. Saturday the 28th, 5 to 9 at the Newcastle Fairgrounds. Now, isn't that something? Yeah, I mean, if you've been watching Newswatch all week, a little bit here, a little bit there, you get the idea of what's going on all around the county. Plus a little state, a little federal in Mike Kelly, because I'm going to tell you what our representatives say. You know. And that's why, you know, Mike Kelly's been in here. We've interviewed Mike Kelly several times. Chris Sonata's been in here. And, why, every Meet the Candidate, we've extended the invitation. Mark Alisco's been in here. But Chris Fry has not come in. And... I hate to keep beating a horse. There's 39 days till Election Day. And he says he believes in small business. Maybe just not this small business. We have to see. Now, let's hear from these sponsors. We'll be right back. There's more than meets the eye. Got a gift from the Newcastle, I tried. There are small town forever. Look around.
Special thanks going out to Town Mall Pizza for sponsorship of this program, located in the Cascade Galleria, Newcastle.
At our law firm, we see you. Come see us at lgkg.com.
Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450, Newcastle's community television station.
Well, folks, that's going to do it here for this Thursday morning, the 26th of September. Here's hoping that you tell a friend and have a friend tell a friend about NCTV 45. And I'd like to thank everybody. When we look at our numbers, up 500%. We had new viewers join us in droves, and quite a few other things that were so positive, a lot of warm sentiments thought, and I'd like to thank you for that. So make sure you tell a friend and have a friend tell a friend about NCTV 45. You know, we're available anytime on your time. The train that runs on your schedule, that's NCTV 45. Hockey's coming, believe me. And Mr. Carmichael's, I will be in touch because we'll have New Wilmington, we'll have Neshanic, we'll have basketball. I am totally looking forward to that and so many of the activities I told you about this week. Make sure that you get the second cup of coffee and have a super day in what I call the greatest castle in the world, in the county of Lawrence. And now, as we leave you, it's the Bee Gees who want you to know you should be dancing. Yeah, that's right. Have a good dance day. We'll see you again real soon. Have a great day, everybody. See you.